Alright. Not going downstairs, let's go here. The door to your Rumpus room. Oh god, more stuff. The Thrash Thrust Snow Globes are the best team to ever play the sport of Lords, and that is simply all there is to say on the matter. Playing for them is your dream. Was, you guess. You sing Fission Division, the new Snow Globes fight song. The central conceit is mostly based around the fact that the team shares its name with the 8-Ball, who contains a nuclear device that will detonate after a certain amount of time has passed. There's no way you'll be able to eat that whole pennant, not with a bent spoon anyway. You consider draping yourself and your team pennant for additional armor, but consult your flart manual first. It suggests that maybe a brightly colored flag waving merrily in the breeze is not the ideal accessory for a hasty escape. Oh wow, did you see that? It waved. You're pretty much sure you just made it wave. Wow. Okay. Awesome. Jeez. Your Zoltan Matsos Bobblenung figurine is the jewel of your collection. You spit fire at the little figurines. You're pretty sure one of them melted a little. Wow, sick. Insane. Oh, the hours of fun you've had, gently bobbling the nug bones, or bopping the nug bones of your bopple nug figurines with a bent spoon, watching them kind of jiggle around, bopping them again. You're really glad someone invented video games. So we have beatboxing and video games in this world. Still, I need a drink. This is a lot of reading here. Ugh, 2 hours, I can't believe it. These are pretty low-threat enemies. They bobble like crazy. It's not exceptionally impressive, since they do that at the slightest brush anyway. You've taken some pretty good thumps to the nug bone in your day. The pusher is the only player allowed to score, so they're prime targets for the opposing defense. The helmet's so worn out that it's basically worthless, except for its sentimental value, which is still pretty low. You can't think of a good rhyme for helmet. Smell it? Hell scent? Velvet? No, those are mostly weak assonants? Not really a great rock to build a church of rhymes on. Well, how do you even know the English language, anyway? Let's see, the defensive stats for a dilapidated helmet are... Wow, this thing would actually lower your defense due to the high probability of destroyed helmet shrapnel going straight into your think pan. Pusher helmets traditionally leave the forehead unprotected in order to facilitate your psychic powers. They also facilitate the high probability of your death, so yeah, there's that. Nothing like a little recessed tabletop arena stickball with your best bud. Too bad he's not around right now. Maybe later. You hold up the non-functioning mic and briefly do some lyrical color commentary on your tabletop arena stickball game. Very briefly, since nothing is happening. Wrong kind of table for eating at. Wrong kind of stickball for doing telekinesis on. You blew it. You blew it. You blew it. Oh sure. Like you can apply the stratagems of arena stickball to tabletop arena stickball. As if. Haha, boy, you're really chortling over that notion. That would be cheating. Or would it? You're actually not entirely sure. I guess it wouldn't matter since you're not playing against anyone anyway. Nah, recessed tabletop arena stickball isn't very fun by yourself. It's not very much like arena stickball either. There's too many things. It's your Cubat, the most prized piece of arena stickball equipment. Better bring this with you. You wedge the bent spoon in between the hilt and the wall and... Yes, you got the Cubat! Why didn't even mean to do that? This thing packs a wallop. Especially when the tip is chalked and it's carried by you. Okay. Yeah, you've gone down the road before. You used to have a lot more of these. This thing's too worn out to protect anything, and you don't really feel like carrying around a keepsake of all the times things are actually trying to hurt you. Still, you think you'll stop short of actually smashing into pieces with your Cubat. As an instrument, it lacks the precision necessary for operations at this scale. Some pushers are so psychically gifted that they wield their Cubats exclusively through telekinesis, leaving their hands free. You are not one of those pushers. You're a scrapper, and you like to hold your Cubat in your hands. In particular, you like the ricochet of power that shoots up your arms as you smack the hell out of things with it. Also, you're less likely to pass out from psychic strain that way. Hey, maybe your flat manual has some tips to improve your martial prowess with your Cubat. Let's see. Melee weapons? Apply your Mox points and pulse stat to your Whammo adjuster. Okay, that's 3 plus 3 minus... No, wait. Maybe your Cubat is actually an improvised melee weapon? So instead, you want to divide your yes and ratio by your swing reserve, then add your number of current accessible sky-high slots, expanding one slot for each level of... Oh, dang it. You guessed a Cubat probably is an improvised melee weapon, sports. So you do the same stuff as with an improvised melee weapon, only you need to refer to the Grand Slam Grimoire as supplement that a FLARP supplement that has been out of print for 5 sweeps. Okay. Maybe you can roll the manual up in your offhand and beat enemies with that, or read the stupid thing aloud to them and put them to sleep. Unlike spoons, Cubats are really difficult to bend with psychic powers. Otherwise, it'd be really easy to sabotage rival pushers. You're a lot better with the Cubat than you are with the mic, even when the mic is working. Okay. The Thrash Thrust Snow Globes are the best team ever, period. The worst thing about being on the run is your chances of playing for them one day are technically zero now. Your Splay Sack, a chair bag filled with Sorper Slime. Proximity to the slime helps you relax without actually making you fall asleep like your Recuper Raccoon does. Some trolls actually eat Sorper Slime, which helps them be really stupid. You lay down a Splay Sack diss track. It's really devastating. You really dig into a bunch of personal stuff that would normally be off the table, just totally pulling no punches. You're pretty sure your friendship with the Splay Sack is never coming back from this, and you don't even care. You scrape at the side of the Splay Sack with your bent spoon. You sure do that. My gosh. When this thing puts you to sleep, at least you have a good place to land. You give the Splay Sack's sorper interior a brisk jostling. This is just good housekeeping, really. You would, but geez, Splay Sack guts all over your TV? No thanks. Okay, so what's this? Zulian Matsos was the greatest pusher the Snow Globes ever had. No Prowler could catch him, no Zapper could blast him, and no matter what Lusus the Wrangler said on him, Matsos would shake him off. That ended the night the heiress of that era attended the game, and her opposing controller made Matsos thrust his bone nook at her. She had him cold right there in the velvet. This wasn't the current heiress, of course. This was a long time ago before you were hatched. Okay. History there. You look at the poster of your hero, Zoltan Matsos. You've always felt a pretty deep connection with him, even though he died long before you were born. Sometimes, you've never told anyone this, but sometimes when things got really rough out there in the velvet, or when you're just feeling kind of crummy even, you sing the old Snow Globes fight song to yourself and pretend Zoltan is there. Not really doing anything, just believing in you. It always helps. Is that what I did with this? Yeah. Haha, geez, looking at a psychic giant like Zoltan while holding this pitiful thing kind of makes you embarrassed. Whole silverware drawers probably tied themselves in knots just because he was walking down the street nearby, and you struggled to bend a spoon. Hey now, is that anyone to think? You know what, Zoltan sure wouldn't want you to be down on yourself because you were looking at his poster. He would want you to believe in yourself. Remember what he said, if you can bend them, they can't break you. Zoltan Matsos isn't listed in your FLARP manual, probably because his stats would be too incredibly high for mere mundane numbers to track. They'd have to create a whole module just about him, where he fights against versions of himself from other timelines. It'd be the only way to make it challenging. Wow, that sounds awesome. Sorry, guys. If you make it through this present craziness, you're definitely going to think about possibly writing that down somewhere or something. Zoltan's telekinesis. It was like nothing anyone had ever seen. Rust Bloods can get pretty powerful, but he was like something from history. From one of those legal parts of history you're not supposed to know about. Where he really got going, or when he really got going, the whole stadium would rumble in his psychic wake. Lately, you've kind of secretly suspected that maybe his death wasn't just a result of some Blue Blood controller prank. Maybe they were taking him out before he became too dangerous for them to handle. Jeez, just look at that form. Just look at his face. He looks like he could break the world in half with that Cubat. You've tried to emulate his non-traditional stance, and you think it's given you the edge more than once. If only you had the psychic chops that Zoltan had. Oh well, no point in dreaming. Okay, what's left? We've got a little thing, we've got the TV, I guess, we got this thing. We got all this. What is this little thing? They release a new arena stock stickball game grub like 6 times a sweep, and every time you buy it like a sucker and act surprised when nothing's different. It's like, what are they gonna do? Change the rules? Nah, you're pretty busy right now. Only chumps play video games when they have obligations they should be tending to. I'm a chump. You have to crack open the controller to sync them, and it's pretty gross. Pus gets everywhere. That sounds like a good way to ruin the controller or unruin the spoon, and you're unwilling to do either. You need a fresh game grub to flarp. Also, you need someone else to play with. Short on both counts, idiot. Jeez. Manipulating the buttons and sticks is really great training exercise for precision telekinesis. Unfortunately, the best you can manage is to lift the controller and then drop it. So you're kind of shining a turd here. Oh yeah, you've broken controllers before in wild fits of frustration before. Well, maybe you should say rustration? You really shouldn't. Paused right at the height of exciting sport. Your mic can't interface with your TV, especially when your mic doesn't have any batteries. We need batteries again. Maybe the batteries... Maybe Joey's batteries can fit in that. That would be really unlikely. The player on the pause screen is unimpressed by your bent spoon. Wow, you've been big leagued by a static image. It will take sweeps to recover from this hit to your rep. You don't flop with a TV, you flop with a game grub. Also, you don't flop at all by yourself, or when your best friend is in peril. Wow, you're pretty sure you just made the screen flicker. You were blinking, but you're pretty sure. Sometimes you just know these things. Nothing, okay. What's this? The crest of the Alternian Pro Arena Stickball League. So it looks like the thing that holds all the pool balls and the pool balls inside. With all 15 balls, in a real game of arena stickball, these are all different sizes and each has its own distinct powers. You lay down some pretty complex verse in which you compare yourself to the various balls in sequence, likening their attributes to various elements of your own personality and history. Wow, it's really good. You should write it down before... Ah, it's gone. You look into concave side of the bent spoon, hoping the distorted reflection of the stickball crest will allow you to escape your preconceptions and see the game in a whole new way, just completely destroying everyone with your sick lateral thinking and non-traditional playstyle. No dice. The balls in there... balls are all set in there pretty firmly. You could maybe wobble the whole thing off the wall, but you really don't want to break it. Also, you're really unsure about your ability to wobble it off the wall, and that would be an embarrassing thing to fail at. Oh, no one's watching. Oh, this isn't working here? Okay. Not complaining. So... it's your sports vault. Just a huge heavy vault themed with sports. Arena stickball, specifically, and obviously. is the only place in the hive you store food for your Lusus. He's so strong he could easily break into any other hiding place. It has a special telekinesis-based interface. It tends to wear you out a little, and the combination is really, or pretty hard to remember. This is all the same thing? Yep. What's this? Oh, still the vault. You drop some rebellious anti-establishment rhymes about vaults and your Lusus and some other half-formed concepts about the caste system. It's pretty solid, but the vault is having none of it. You could maybe pick the lock with this bent spoon if it were a little sharper and if you knew how to do that, and if this vault actually featured a tumbler-based lock, which it doesn't. You have a feeling you're bending up the wrong spoon on this one. Picking this lock is way above your challenge rating. You should probably put your mind to figuring out another way to open it. Your cubat is way too big for the precise, delicate, intellectual sports maneuvers necessary to solve the sports vault locking mechanism. Okay, can we use our stuff here? What do I do? That's me? Wait, okay. I'm controlling it, I think. Am I doing that? No, no! I got eaten by a crab. You died at the end. That's what that says. I can read that. Oof, that's a rough one. It can be hard to remember the path when you're already concentrating on your shaky telekinesis. It helps if you have some kind of guide on hand. You've got just the thing, but you don't think it's in this room. Okay, so we need to go elsewhere. Got it. Okay, so now we have this thing so we can whack things with the cubat. You know, maybe scarab bristling isn't so bad if you think of the scarab bristle as a cubat and imagine that the dirt on the floor is actually the opposing team during the championship finals. Score is tied, 30 seconds on the clock, and it's all down to the wire. And, no, you're just not feeling this at all, sorry. Scarab bristling sucks forever. Yeah, you kind of hate the smear spinner, but it's pretty expensive, and you don't exactly have a lot of extra money to throw around. In fact, you never have enough, by law. It's Imperial mandate that Rust Bloods not have more than the bare minimum to scrape by, lest they become too powerful, you guess. Sure, you'd love to use this cubat to utterly clean Hive at the arena, but that doesn't mean it belongs with the actual cleaning supplies. Okay, so let's mess with the cubat in here, and then I guess we'll go downstairs. Nothing. If you won slam or got cold, there'd be no time for push or practice. Not that there's any time for it now, really, what with the rebellion and everything. Well, this is this thing. These stick jammers are holding the poster in pretty well on their own. No full force strike with your cubat needed. You just kind of press them into your semi-soft wall using the power of your own digits. Yep, there's your arena stickball gear, specially made to take hits from any and all arena stickball hazards. Getting burned by the match tip or blasted by the opposing zapper, or mauled by a Lusus controlled by the opposing wrangler, or really any number of other things. It doesn't really take any of those hits especially well, of course, but it does take them. Okay, the thing that reminds me of Quidditch from Harry Potter. You always gotta shake off the slimies a bit before you're in your prime vigor. What does that mean? It goes to the left of the chitin ridger, of course. They require a more delicate touch, or rather, no touch at all. Maybe many's the time you imagine taking your cubat to all this depressing junk. Smashing it to unrecognizable pieces would feel so good, even for a few minutes. Then you'd remember that you need this stuff to practice your buttling, which you need to be good enough to pass your trials or you'll be called. And this stuff is expensive. If anything happened to it, it'd be a sweep or two before you could even afford another set. You don't have a sweeper to spare. Okay. I think that was everything. Oh wait, we got this. Each of the different balls has their own unique effect. Although that's actually a lighting fixture, not a real set of balls. If you were to strike it with your cubat, like you just considered doing, the only effect they produce would be broken glass and possible electrocution. Oh, that's all. Alright. Go downstairs. More stuff. A door. Your Imperial Edict mounted portrait of the heiress. She rules your planet with a perfectly manicured golden fist. You know it's perfectly manicured because she recently issued an imperial memorandum about her new nail art. The drones outside are doing her dirty work. She'll have a shiny top coat of blood after tonight, all of it common hued, you're sure. If the heiress ever heard your revolutionary music, you'd be cold within the hour. Maybe that's what's going on right now? You doubt it. You're basically completely outknown outside of Outclot. The heiress has probably never seen silverware before. Not that this is real silver. She only eats off of gold plates that she throws away after a single use. Well, that's not really fair. She doesn't throw them away, obviously. She has servants do that for her, along with everything else. You can't imagine the heiress playing Flarp unless she got to play as a super high-level character with an exclusive class and everyone else had to lose on purpose while shrieking about how great she is. Sounds fun. Tetrarch Demic insists that the aristocracy fears the powers of those beneath it, like your rust blood telekinesis and brown blood Lusus communion. Oh really, Lusus communion? He sometimes neglects to mention that your telekinesis isn't all that fearsome, which is nice of him occasionally. Oh wow, it's tempting, but that'd be dangerous to even dream about. Literally. The chuckle voodoos of the heiress's subjugulators in waiting would pursue you to the darkest corners of your own mind and beat you to death with their juggling clubs, laughing while like lunatics the whole time. Okay. Got it. Okay, we got some over here. You subscribe to a wide variety of hip periodicals. Arena, Stickball, Illustrated, Grubs, Diurnally. Those are actually the only titles you know. The rest always incorporate the magazine's name on the cover into some sick graphic design to the point where you can't actually tell what the name is. This one with the graffiti of a muscle beast throwing up is usually about movies, though. Usually. That's a dream, man. Get yourself on the cover of one of these babies. Preferably not talentless nobodies, though. Frankly, you're not even sure why you subscribe to that one. Bent spoons are in. Or rather, a single bent spoon is in. It is in your Silidex. Okay. Your Flarp manual does have information about magazines, but they're the kind with bullets. You don't have any of those around, unless Tetrarch Demic has hidden secret ammo caches throughout your hive again without telling you. Correction, you probably have thousands of those around. You probably just end up accidentally ripping the covers off, which would destroy their value to collectors. The latest issue of Arena Stickball Illustrated has a big expose on chalking your cubat. They're claiming it doesn't really do anything but enhance your performance. You're more than a little disappointed to see this once proud publication resort to preposterous lies to grab attention. Everyone knows that cubat chalk is the pulsing lifeblood of the sport of lords. Okay. That goes off. Stuff here. Stuff. As a rustblood, you're not permitted to have luxurious circular desks, only the standard hexagons. Huh. There's like a phone here or something. Alright, never mind. Eh, the theme song isn't really something you could sing. Just a lot of beeps. The hero of this show once took someone's eye out with a spoon and ate it. It was gruesome, but the security of the Empire was at stake. Why play a game when you can passively engage in a narrative? Right? Better not. Even powers as weak as yours will erase data like a magnet. No, you saved up for weeks for this box set, and it promises to offer at least 1/7 of 1 week of entertainment. Oh, a day? I think they call those days. There's a tree growing through here. A TV. This might be all one, I'm not sure. Let's look at this. I have to go over there to look at it. These lounge planks aren't full of sorper slime or anything like that. They're just comfortable horizontal surfaces suited to either the sitting or lying prone positions. You can't really summon any revolutionary lyrical rhetoric about your own lounge plank. Maybe something about very basic comforts being a blinder that prevents you from seeing the danger of your present situation? Well, that's a little corny and underdeveloped. Tetrachdamic would really take you to task over that one. Just because it's near the kitchen doesn't mean your lounge plank is food. You resolve to pull yourself together a bit. The perfect staging area for adventures of your mind. FLARP is actually an adventure of the flesh as well. Your lounge plank is way too heavy to move with telekinesis. You're not ashamed to admit that. A good drubbing would really put this lounge plank in its place if it weren't already there. You designed your hive around this tree, hoping it would grow along with you and your Lusus. Did it? You know a sad song about a tree, but you don't feel like singing it right now. Maybe another time. Maybe you can carve Tetrachdamic and friend Xefros forever. But, oh gosh, you would, of course, ask his permission first. Interior trees grant +3 to your decor's whimsy stat. You did it! You moved a leaf! A big branch fell off this tree during a solar storm, and you carved it into the cubat you now carry. Okay. TV, we got news going on? Oh, we're changing channels. That's changing channels as well, okay. Okay. Let's go this way, I guess. We've still got that door to the kitchen, I'm guessing. I thought the Lusus was behind that other door, upstairs. Let's look around. A playbook for the Burgundy Blood Pusher position in Arena Stickball. You still have dreams of playing, being a star pusher, and studying these killer plays was going to help take you to the top. To the top. But your play on the field never quite lived up to the aesthetic promise of your fantasies. Also, the closer your rites of maturation get, the more the sobering reality sinks in that you'll never get to play professionally. Life of butlering? Here you come. You guess. Okay. Can't use anything there, and that's off. Look at that, it's nearly escaped from your impending death o'clock. You better not be late. You generate some truly impressive verse utilizing a time motif. For some reason, time and rapping seem inextricably linked in your head. Trying to hold the minute hand in place actually sounds like a pretty good TK exercise. Once you get tired of ruining your silverware. Alright, we can take this, right? Great, another thing. You pick up the Pusher Playbook. Now, if a situation arises where you'll need to remember a particular play, you'll be well equipped to do so. You resolve to keep an eye out for just such a contrivance. Full of all the complex plays a pusher needs to keep themselves from becoming a burgundy stain on the velvet. There aren't any pusher plays that incorporate rapping, but there aren't any that particularly prohibit wrapping either. You're not allowed to bring improvised weapons on the Velvet. There are plenty of regular weapons there already, so it would be kind of redundant. You compare the rules for playing FLARP to the playbook for ruling. You mean for playing Arena Stick FLARP? Stickball, you mean? And you, you reference both, and I'm determined that, you have a headache. Your pusher playbook advises that you rely heavily on your telekinesis, something you're not at all that comfortable doing, as your telekinesis is not all that reliable. You tend to lead with your Cubat. There's a lot in here about the modern consensus on how you should hold your Cubat. The right grip, level, stance, keep your head down, swing your hips, eyes on the ball, good hustle, ice your knee, etc. You never really paid it any mind. The first time you saw a poster of Zoltan Matsos holding his Cubat, you knew you were going to hold it for the rest of your life. Okay. This clock, stuff on this. Arena Stickball is played in 2 11-hour halves. It's grueling. Alright, we did that. Trying to hold a minute hand in place actually sounds like a pretty good TK exercise once you get tired of ruining your silverware. There's a whole section about using the time of day to encrypt messages. Demick is always trying to teach you this stuff, but it's so hard to keep track of, and also to care about. Sounds like a great way to just completely destroy an unsuspecting clock for no reason. You turn the minute hand back slightly. Oh, if only it were that easy to turn back time, to undo the mistakes of... Oof, actually that minute hand thing kind of wore you out a bit. Alright, so I'm not going to mess with this guy yet. We can also go out. Jeez. Grub juice hydration cylinders. Inside these cylindrical containers is grub juice, which can be used for hydration and restoring reserves of psychic power. Oh, so we can solve the thing upstairs. The vault. You pick up the grub juice hydration cylinders. Nice. Now if you need a quick restorative for your psychic stamina, you'll just have that. In your hand. Instead of not having it, like some kind of chump. Sometimes when you're feeling especially rebellious, you wish all the good toppings weren't reserved for high bloods. Eating an unarranged cluck beast ova, ew, is a great way to fill your acid tubes with horrifying parasites who probably wouldn't get along with your benevolent parasites or your benign parasites. Cake! Left over from Tetrarch Demick's early wriggling day party. He doesn't turn 7 sweeps old for a couple wipes, but you wanted to celebrate him before his rites of maturation. Ugh, these are still in here? Bioslaw doesn't really keep well. Ah, delicious grub sauce. Hand sauce from... you're not sure, actually. You don't ask about grub sauce. That's not what you do with grub sauce. Always useful in case you need to whip up a souffle. You're bad at that, but it's a mandatory part of your future job, so... Okay. Now we got grub juice.